Welcome to Field of Flowers. For 100 years, our family-owned flower business has been continually improved to serve customers with the freshest flowers and the lushest ornamental plants possible. Enter into any of our Field of Flowers locations, and you'll see more than 150 varieties of colorful fresh-cut flowers by the stem or the bunch. A selection of elegantly designed floral arrangements for pickup and delivery. An assortment of beautifully cultivated potted flowering plants and plant arrangements. Traditional and designer pots and planters to complement homes and offices. Sales associates who are ready to help you. Designers with ideas and experience to create magnificent arrangements for any occasion. Classes for people who are interested in learning to design floral arrangements. Event consultants who work with bridal parties and event coordinators to provide color-coordinated floral arrangements for that special day. And behind these doors, we have state-of-the-art cooling equipment to extend the freshness of cut flowers. And employees who are taking online and phone orders for delivery worldwide. These and other important differences make Field of Flowers unlike any other flower market in the world. Yes, it's a big claim, but please take a few moments to listen to our family's century-old story, and you will understand why we are different. It all began with James Don, my grandfather.
Born in Lanark, Scotland, to a blacksmith and the second youngest of eight brothers and sisters, young Jimmy was apprenticed to nurseryman William Sturrock when his parents realized he did not have the strength to swing a hammer. In 1909, at age 22, Jimmy immigrated to America with a letter of introduction to a New York City florist and a few dollars in his pocket. He worked as a landscaper on John D. Rockefeller's estate, and for other famous industrialists of the day, Andrew Carnegie and George Gould. He also met his future wife, a red-cheeked, dark-eyed beauty, Nellie Whitefield, a lady's maid who, coincidentally, was born a few miles from his hometown in Scotland. Jimmy decided in 1912 to make his own fortune, moving to a community near Jacksonville, Florida, to work as an ornamental shrub manager. He asked Nellie to join him in Jacksonville, where they married. As they honeymooned in Miami, the couple saw opportunity in the bustling port city and decided to stay. One of his first jobs was to help landscape the Deering Estate's beautiful Vizcaya Gardens. The Dons decided in 1915 to start a landscaping and florist business and bought the Miami branch of the Jacksonville landscaping firm where Jimmy had worked, changing the name to Exotic Gardens after winning a floral contest using non-native exotic plants. His business reputation grew as Jimmy landscaped other millionaires' estates in Miami. The young couple also delivered flowers to customers by horse and buggy. Jimmy was gregarious and likable, reciting the writings of Scottish poets, easily holding conversations, possessing a sharp mind for business, and building relationships based on trust. He grew the landscaping and floral business, hiring people who worked hard and had a desire to grow with the business. Several employees worked for him for more than 65 years. In 1925, Exotic Gardens joined a new flower ordering system, Florist Telegraph Delivery, now known as FTD, so that his customers could have flowers delivered anywhere in the US. The family's flower business flourished. Exotic Gardens eventually operated 10 stores in South Florida and Jacksonville. The business expanded its flower and plant growing operations to nurseries in Miami and Davie. A fleet of trucks delivered fresh flowers and plants to homes and businesses throughout South Florida. As the business grew, so did the Don family. Jimmy's daughter Helen married Fred Flipsey, a World War II veteran whose family grew fruit trees in Dade County and who eventually became Exotic Gardens chairman. Fred and Helen's son Don Flipsey grew up in the business. It's said that the first word that he spoke was flower.
I had worked at various jobs at the company from an early age, but never as a designer. My mentor and other designers at the store taught me floral design during the next year. I had a degree from a good college, but this was like getting my master's degree in floristry. I still remember the satisfaction of seeing a customer select an arrangement from the cooler that I had created and happily paying his money for it. That's sort of the essence of our business. During the next few years, I managed a few different locations, and then my father, who was the president, made me the general manager overseeing the stores, the nursery, and the wholesale florist business. About 1980, I became president, and my father remained as chairman.
Under his guidance, the company began importing flowers from South America, Europe, and even Asia. After Jimmy Don's passing in 1972, the Don and Flipsy families continued to operate Exotic Gardens until 1989. Although Exotic Gardens was no longer part of his family, Don Flipsy's passion for the business did not fade. If anything, he felt it was unfinished and decided to continue the family floral business.
I not only had worked at Exotic for nearly 20 years, but had also visited many types of flower stores and markets all around the US and Europe. I felt that I could take that experience and create a better kind of flower market. After discussing it with my wife, Diana, we decided to start a new company that would create and operate such a store.
With family members and several business partners, he developed the idea for a spacious and welcoming floral store that systematically provided consumers with a fresher and a wider variety of flowers than other florist shops. But first, the business needed a name.
I remember that we considered dozens, maybe hundreds, including, of course, Flipsy Flowers. The movie Field of Dreams had been a big hit the year before. It was an inspirational, romantic, feel-good movie. When someone eventually came up with Field of Flowers, everyone loved it immediately.
Field of Flowers opened in 1990 in Davie, Florida, in suburban Fort Lauderdale and in the heart of South Florida. Stores were later opened in Boca Raton and Palmetto Bay. Field of Flowers was established to be a different kind of flower store, with 21,000 square feet of showroom, office and storage space, a welcoming layout drawing people in. A wider array and larger variety of flowers than traditional florist shops, including flowers for walk-in customers and delivery that are in bunches, stems, by the box, and in arrangements with a range of pricing to suit all budgets for all occasions. Field of Flowers' success stems from being the easiest place to shop from the biggest selection of the freshest flowers at the lowest prices. Field of Flowers continually strives for quality, from the appearance of its stores, the type of people that it hires, to keeping flowers fresher by treating and nourishing them to last longer. After its first successful century of growth, Field of Flowers and the Flipsies are continuing Jimmy Don's legacy of beautiful flowers and outstanding customer service for future generations of customers to enjoy.
My grandparents and parents believed that the only way to have a happy, healthy company was to provide the highest quality products and service at the best price. In other words, we must make our customers happy. The Field of Flowers Board of Directors, on which I am joined by my wife, daughter, and oldest son, is dedicated to making our legacy a company that continues to grow by adding happiness to the lives of customers, associates, suppliers, and perhaps future generations of Flipsies.